Breaking news in the 2020 race this morning. A new Democratic mayor is entering the contest. Wayne Messam, mayor of Miramar, Florida, just put out this video moments ago.
America belongs to all of us. The promise of America belongs to all of us.
That's why I'm going to be running for president, to be your champion.
I'm very proud of you.
Yes.
The same prospects of the American dream that my father was able to achieve. We need to bring that back for every American.
Joining us now is Mayor Wayne Messam, again, the mayor of Miramar, Florida. Mr. Mayor, thank you so much for being with us this morning. And just to be blunt about this, I think a lot of people are seeing this announcement and are saying, who? From where? Explain.
Well, good morning, John. How are you? You know, John, I'm from Miramar, Florida, one of a major city in the state of Florida. I'm the son of immigrants. My father came to this country from Jamaica as a contract sugarcane cutter, cutting cane for 75 cents a roll of sugarcane, chasing the American dream. And I'm living that American dream. And but I see that American dream slipping away for a lot of Americans. You know, I had an opportunity to play football at Florida State, national champion for legendary coach Bobby Bowden. I actually started a construction business with my wife, and we are actually a climate conscious business. And now I'm the mayor of a major city of Florida with one of the fastest growing economies. You know, as mayor, while other cities are losing jobs and manufacturing to China, we actually are taking jobs away from China. We passed a living wage in our city. I guided our city through Hurricane Irma. You know, I'm suing the state of Florida so local mayors can be able to fight and advocate for gun control in their cities. And right now, we're actually fighting oil drilling right outside of our city. You know, so these are very important issues that have national implications. And I'm looking forward to be that agent of change for the American people, and so excited to launch my candidacy to be the president of the United States.
And just by means of comparison, Miramar has a population of what, 140,000? Roughly?
Yes, we're approaching 150,000 residents. We are a major city in South Florida. We have one of the fastest growing economies in America.
The reason I'm bringing that up, Mayor, is because South Bend, Indiana, where Pete Buttigieg is from, and we just showed a poll showing him with major movement in the Democratic race, actually has fewer residents. That's why I was bringing that up. So Miramar is a city that is growing with a significant population. I want to put up another poll here, because CNN has asked Democratic voters the quality they most want to see in a Democratic nominee, and 49% say a good chance to beat Trump. That is the most important quality, according to the last CNN poll. And my question to you, and I put this to all Democratic candidates, why are you the best Democratic candidate in your mind to beat President Trump? Better in your mind than the other Democratic candidates?
Well, you know, first off, Trump doesn't deserve to be reelected. America has lost its footing internationally, and he's made a lot of promises that haven't been kept for America. But when you look at mayors, mayors get the job done. We don't have the luxury to shut down our governments. And when you look at what we're doing in the city of Miramar in terms of bringing high-wage jobs to America, taking jobs away from China, we're actually taking head-on issues in terms of gun control, issues in terms of our environment. These are really important issues. And America needs an individual who will look at the issues that are important to the American people with the sense of urgency of today. The gradualism is not accepted. Mm-hmm. And I'm not convinced that the solutions are coming from Washington. And so, that's why I think why the polls are showing that the American people are looking for someone who has actually done the work are closest to the people and can beat Donald Trump.
Let me ask you, one of the major issues that you are running on is student debt and erasing, to a certain extent, student loans, $1.3 trillion in student debt that is out there. How are you going to do that?
Well, you know, when you look at the $1.5 trillion in outstanding student loan debt, it's crippling American people, it's hampering our economy. There's been a lot of talk about high costs for access to college. But before of course, those are important issues, but we have to address the $1.5 trillion that Americans owe right now. And when you contemplate the nearly $2 trillion in tax cuts to the rich and to corporations, a repeal of that is more than enough resources to be able able to handle that outstanding debt. Let's give American people a second chance at that American dream, the same American dream that attracted my parents to this country and that I'm having the ability to lead. And American people deserve a shot to be able to make the decisions like to buy a home, to be able to have access to health care. Mm-hmm. You know, seniors are actually making the decision whether to fill their prescription or to buy some food to eat. America, we are better than that. And we need the leadership that will make these issues a priority and have the political will to solve these issues for the American people.
Mayor Wayne Messam from Miramar, Florida, thank you for being with us. We wish you the best of luck and look forward to continuing this conversation.
Thank you, and I look forward to getting our message out to the American people.
Thanks, Mayor.